Evening. Here we are, the last part of another day. My goodness me. Let's come before the Lord and bring him our prayers. Evening, the last.
Tiny speak, Ruffle.
The Lord Almighty grant us a quiet night and a perfect end.
Amen. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth. And so a moment of reflection on the day now coming to its close. And we bring to mind the things of the day that could have gone better, perhaps. We say, most merciful God,
we confess to you
before the whole company of heaven and one another that we have sinned in thought and word and deed and in what we have failed to do. Forgive us our sins, heal us by your Spirit, and raise us to new life in Christ. Amen.
O God, make speed to save us.
O Lord, make haste to help us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son,
and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Before the ending of the day, Creator of the world, we pray that you, with steadfast love, would keep your watch around us while we sleep. From evil dreams defend our sight, from fears and terrors of the night. Tread underfoot our deadly foe, that we no sinful thought may know. O Father, that we ask be done through Jesus Christ, your only Son. And Holy Spirit, by whose breath our souls are raised to life from death. Psalm 139. O Lord, you have searched me out and known me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You discern my thoughts from afar.
You mark out my journeys and my resting place, and are acquainted with all my ways.
For there is not a word on my tongue, but you, O Lord, know it altogether.
You encompass me behind and before, and lay your hand upon me.
Such knowledge is too wonderful for me, so high that I cannot attain it.
Where can I go then from your presence? Or where can I flee from your Spirit?
If I climb up to heaven, you are there. If I make the grave my bed, you are there also.
If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea,
even there your right hand shall lead me, your right hand shall hold me fast.
If I say, surely the darkness will cover me, and the light around me turn to night.
Even darkness is no darkness with you. The night is as clear as the day. Darkness and light to you are both alike.
For you yourself created my inmost parts. You knit me together in my mother's womb.
I thank you, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvellous are your works, my soul knows well.
My frame was not hidden from you when I was made in secret and woven in the depths of the earth.
Your eyes beheld my form as yet unfinished. Already in your book were all my members written.
As day by day they were fashioned, when as yet there was none of them.
How deep are your counsels to me, O God! How great is the sum of them!
If I count them, they are more in number than the sand. And at the end, I am still in your presence.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Isaiah 58, verses 6 and 7. Is this not the fast that I choose? To loose the bonds of injustice, to undo the thongs of the yoke, to let the oppressed go free and to break every yoke? Is it not to share your bread with the hungry and bring the homeless poor into your house? When you see the naked, to cover them, and not to hide yourself from your own kin. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
For you have redeemed me, Lord God of truth.
I commend my spirit. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Into your hands, O Lord,
I commend my spirit.
Keep me as the apple of your eye.
Hide me under the shadow of your wings.
Christ died for us,
so that whether we wake or sleep, we might live with him.
Now, Lord, you let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people, Israel.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen. Christ died for us, so that whether we wake or sleep, we might live with him. Father, as we come to the close of our day, we bring before you all that the day has been. We bring before you the opportunities and the challenges, the blessings given and received, the joys and the pain. Father God, we thank you that we are yours, and that you are with us, in sun and in rain, in good and in bad. Lord, we thank you that as we gather up the remnants of this day and prepare for bed, we do so knowing that you are with us, that we are yours, and your love, your light and your peace are but a fingertip away. Father, we thank you for your presence and grace in us this night. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Father, as we prepare to go to bed tonight, we pray for those whose night times are unsettled, especially those who are confused or who suffer with mental health, those whose thoughts are chaotic, those whose grasp on reality is sometimes flimsy. Lord, we pray that you will protect them.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, help them to find clarity, help them to find security, a place of safety.
Yes.
Lord, we pray that the resources and the support would be available for them.
Mm-hmm.
Lord, we pray that we would be gentle and loving in our dealings with those who are perhaps a bit different, a bit strange, not like us. Lord, that we would always treat everyone with respect. And we would do what we can to help where we can. Lord, give us grace, give us wisdom, and where we need to find other help, Lord, guide us, help us to help those who need professional help. Lord, we pray for all who may be afraid tonight because they don't quite understand what's going on around them. They don't quite understand the world around them. Lord, we pray that you would come close and bring them comfort. May they feel safe.
Mm.
And keep them safe until the morning, Lord. We ask in your precious name.
Yes.
Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer.
Father, we pray for those who are troubled this night. We pray for those this night who are confused, fearful, stressed, especially troubled within their minds. And Father, as we pray for those things, we pray for those who gather, who protest, who keep vigils, who in making a statement, in voicing their fear, place themselves in risk from infection, act whatever reason behind in a wrong way according to the things that the government put before us. Father, may we always stand against that which is wrong. May we always stand with the broken, with the fearful, with those who grieve. But Lord, may we never lose sight of the fact that no matter how right the cause, the way we discharge it brings us to a place where we make real or deny the very things we stand for. Father God, you've called us to always oppose wrong, but you call us to oppose wrong in the right way, to obey the governments, to keep the law of God and the law of man, and to act within that, that we would pull down strongholds by prayer and right actions. So Father, we pray for all this night who will gather in Parliament Square. We pray for the police that they would do their job well, and that others would see no need to be there perhaps. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer.
Father, we pray for ourselves as we go into our beds, that we will go there knowing that we are loved, that we are cherished, that we are surrounded by your angels. That we are protected and we are provided for, because we have a bed to go to.
Yes.
So Lord, we pray for those who tonight will sleep on streets, on beaches, in tents, in doorways. For those who have no home to call their own. For those whose home is now a refugee camp. Lord, we pray for their safety. We pray that they may soon find a home to call their own.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer. Almighty God, may we, by the prayer and discipline of Lent, enter into the mystery of Christ's suffering, that by following in the way, we may come to share in the glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
And so we pray with confidence. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Your kingdom come. Your will be done
on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
In peace we will lie down and sleep. For you alone, Lord, make us dwell in safety.
Abide with us, Lord Jesus, for the night is at hand,
and the day is now past. As the night watch looks for the morning,
so do we look for you, O Christ. May God bless us, that in us may be found love and humility, obedience and thanksgiving, discipline, gentleness and peace. Amen.
Thank you for being with us. Sorry about the Lord's Prayer. The machine decided to get into a bit of a brainstorm.
Sleep well. Stay safe. No doubt catch you tomorrow. Good night.
Good night.